Kelly Golob, who's the captain of Team Smith and Wesson, and one very, very fine pistol shooter. I've seen her in action, and not only is she gorgeous, she's really fast and really accurate. Kelly, what would you have to say to a champion like Julie?
Well, first off, honored to meet you.
Likewise. Okay.
So, for someone like myself who's got a background primarily in accuracy shooting, where time really isn't an issue, now I'm trying to make a transition to do some pistol shooting myself, where all of a sudden accuracy and speed matter. What sort of, what would be some good 2 cents wisdom that you might give me to start off with?
The biggest challenge for you will probably learning what an acceptable sight picture is.
Acceptable.
Okay. We used to fine-tuning everything.
It's got to be perfect.
Yes. No, it's not so in speed events. So okay. You have an acceptable sight picture, you have an acceptable zone to hit, and that's what you go for.
Okay.
That's what you have to pass through.
So, in essence, can I paraphrase to say you're kind of finding out what you can get away with?
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Now, I heard you're interested in doing some move into three-gun shooting. Is that true?
Yes, that's very true.
That's cool. I'm doing the same thing myself.
Oh, yay. Maybe we'll see each other in range.
Fingers crossed. So, have you done any practicing with that? What gear are you going to be using?
I'm definitely going to be shooting all Smith & Wessons for my rifle and my pistol at the P-line, and then I'll be shooting a Benelli shotgun.
Okay, which one?
Probably the M2, maybe the M4.
Great. So, talking about three gun, is power factor with the ammunition, is that something you have to worry about too?
Yeah, I am so new to three gun that there's a lot of things I'll have to learn. Attention to the rule book. But in any sport, you really need to find out what those minimums are so that you meet them and you can be competitive. It's very important.
I've heard the rule book for three gun is something that would give an encyclopedia a run for its money, so good luck with that.
Likewise.
Okay, so how about on your shotgun, iron sights or optics?
I'm probably going to go with the iron sights on that one. So, I'm still toying with whether I want to go for an open title or a tactical title, I'm not quite sure yet, so...
Title? Already thinking of winning, huh?
Gross.
All right,
You think the same way.
I like the mindset, that's great. So, what would you be shooting for a carbine, your rifle?
The M&P-15.
M&P-15, again with optics?
Probably, again, I don't know. If I'm going to run an optic, I'll most likely run an aim point. Or... I just don't know yet. I'm so new to it that... Gotta figure it out. Just
okay.
Like you.
Gotta figure out what works for you.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got an AR-15 with the red dot I'll use. And I got a Mossberg I'll use with iron sights with a shotgun. So.
You know, the great thing about all of the shooting sports is you just jump in, take the plunge, somebody's gonna lend you their gear, they're gonna help you out, they're gonna say, dude, you need to shoot this or try this out. And by the time you're done with your second match, you'll have tried everything.
Mm-hmm. So going along those lines, I go into a shooting store, I see on posters, I know other people do too. If I was a young girl, thankfully I'm not, but if I was and I wanted to get into shooting and maybe I was worried, shooting's a boy sport, I don't want to do that, would you have any advice to encourage girls to start shooting?
Just give it a try. You got to go for it, you're going to love it, take the plunge, and you'll have so much fun on the range, it'll be fun beating the guys, no offense.
No, girls always shoot great, they do.
Yes, they do, and it's going to be awesome. Go for it.
Well, thank you. It was great to meet you,
Absolutely.
Julie, and best of luck on the range.
Thanks so much.